Hi, I'm Greg Martellotto, owner and founder of Big Hammer Wines. We get a lot of folks that often search our website and are asking the same question. What's the right temperature to serve wine at? It's a great question, and I'm glad you asked, and I'm here to help answer it. The short answer, for most wines, they should be served at cellar temperature. It's about 57 degrees, typically. Well, what does that feel like? Well, if you touch the glass, it actually is cool, almost cold, not chilly, but cold. So you know what your jar of juice or your temperature, your milk tastes like, around 36 or so degrees Fahrenheit. That's too cold for most wines. It's not a problem though to leave your sparkling wine, your champagne, or even your white wines in the refrigerator. Just don't leave them in there for months. There's not enough humidity in the refrigerator, so the corks can dry, which causes them to shrink and the wine could oxidize and not be good over time. But leaving the white wines and sweet wines in your refrigerator is fine. Once you pour a glass in 10 or 15 minutes, it's gonna come up to room temperature, ambient temperature. The biggest mistake we find with service temperature and wine is red wines. Often you'll see people serving red wines at room temperature. This is a big no-no. Room temperature, ambient temperature, is typically between 70 and 80. In a cooler month, you know, it might be in the high 60s. Remember, we said the proper service temperature for most wines is in the high 50s. So how do you get there? If you store your wine at room temperature, hopefully it's in a closet out of light, it's free from vibration and free from drastic temperature change. A quite easy way to chill your red wine is just to put it in the refrigerator for 20 minutes. And it will go from room temperature down to that appropriate service temperature of 57 degrees. Quite easy, simple. You could even pour yourself your first half glass and put the bottle in the refrigerator. By the time you finish your half glass, it'll probably be at the right temperature. After you open a bottle of wine, people often ask, how long does it last? Most wines, by which I mean probably 90% of all wines, are going to oxidize within 24 hours. You have to understand, oxygen is wine's best and worst friend. It's the best friend when wine is fermenting. It's a requirement. You have to have oxygen to interact with sugars to create alcohol that releases CO2. That's the fermentation process. So oxygen is a necessary component in the development of wine, and including when it's aging in barrel. However, after the wine is finished or dry, oxygen becomes wine's worst friend because it leads to what you already know, which is vinegar. Always put the cork back in after you pour a glass of wine. If you leave the cork off, make sure you finish the bottle. But if you keep the cork on that bottle, 24 hours should be okay. And after that, the wine's gonna start going downhill and start turning into acetic acid or vinegar. When I pull a cork on a wine, if I'm not sure I'm gonna finish it, or if say I've got a white and a red and I have half a bottle of each, I put the cork back in and I put the wine in the refrigerator. Why the refrigerator? Well, because lower temperatures means oxygenation is gonna happen at a slower pace. Just as higher temperatures, when you cook something, change happens, right? You caramelize food or brown it quicker at higher temperatures, so too is the opposite. The other thing that people often ask, well, which kind of wines? Sweet wines, for instance, whether they're late harvest, they've got higher sugar levels, they may have higher alcohol if they're fortified, like a port wine. Those wines, you can often just take the cork, pour a glass, and put the cork back in, and put it back in the refrigerator. I'm also referring to wines like vermouth, aromatized wines that may also have a fortification, so a high-proof grape-distilled spirit or brandy added to them. These wines are very amenable for drinking a little glass at a time. And I would say about a month. Once you get past a month in the refrigerator, most of those wines will start going downhill. The other thing that you can do with sparkling wine is utilize one of those special corks. It's got a couple ears and it clasps the bottom of the neck of the champagne bottle, and it helps keep some of the pressure or the bubbles fresh. I've used some of those successfully for up to a week. Thank you for joining us for Adventures in Wine. Cheers.